What is up, YouTube? Wait a second. How come we're dinosaurs today?
I don't know. I guess the Sparckman never had time to make 3D animations. Again.
Eh, I don't care. Like the video and subscribe. I'm gonna go play some Rockbox.
Hey there guys, my name is Sparckman, I'm a game developer. Today we're going to create a Pong game with some artificial intelligence. Usually when you hear the term artificial intelligence, it doesn't actually mean that the computer is going to think. You probably would need a few supercomputers joined together to spawn consciousness. It usually means that the computer interacts with the user as if he was thinking. In other words, can your game pass the Turing test? So don't worry, you're not gonna be responsible for Skynet. Or in the year 2080. When Twitter becomes self-aware. Okay, so here is the question, were you able to tell who was the computer? Okay, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to release commercial titles. Let's go over the assets. I'm going to click on the ball, and you can see that this is a bouncing ball object. These are the settings I'm using. It is an 8-direction object, and I only have 2 directions enabled, up and down. I'm going to click on the AI player, and you can see that this too is a bouncing ball. I'm using these 2 directions as the initial direction. I'm using these objects here to prevent the ball from leaving the play area. All these purple objects, I put them in one group, group of good. And this is for our AI object to go up and down. And here is this green object here, which we are going to use to track the Y position of the ball. And just to be funny, I made the AI icon to look like this. Okay, so let's go to the editor. We interrupt this broadcast to shout out Yoshi3261. Check out his channel. Whoa, what is this? Let's begin with the first collision. Collision between the ball and Grupo Good. We make the ball bounce. Line 2. Collision between the ball and the player. The ball is going to bounce as well. Collision between the ball and our AI object, which is the computer player. In that case, the ball is going to bounce as well. Throw it out. We need to stop the AI. Collision between the AI and the cage. In that case, our AI is going to bounce. Throw it out. That seems to work fine, but our AI doesn't have any intelligence. We're gonna make this object visible at start so you can see what's happening. Under line 5, we're gonna compare this to 2 general values, and we're gonna compare it to the distance between the AI and the ball. Distance was the point, and it's gonna be the X and Y of the ball. X and Y. If the distance is greater than 450, lower than 450, in that case, we're gonna change the position of the green object. The Y position equals the Y position of the ball. Spread out. That works fine. We're gonna make our AI look in direction of the green object. And we're gonna make it start. Movement, start. Let's copy line 5, paste it. Let's edit the condition, greater than 450. So in that case, we don't want to start the AI, but we want to stop it. And we're not gonna track the Y of the ball. Let's make this green object invisible at start. Same as the cage, which is already invisible. Let's try it out. And you can see that that works not too bad. And down below, you can see the like button. Hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first comment and the top comment. And here's the top comment. Gato do espaço. Well, we have no videos. And here is the first comment, Joshua Jones. And no videos.